Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. All of you, that's I spoke in my book. I have a big chapter actually speaking about slavery in Islam. But today, it's always better to hear it from Muslims. Muslims, when they speak in the Middle East, they are different from when they speak to you in English. The hypocrisy is going to be a lot more less. So I'm going to share with you a video, and if you have my book, if you read my book, go and read everything I showed you in slavery in there and compare it to what this woman she is going to say in the video, and you will notice that this woman, she is supposedly a very famous woman. She speaks in Kuwait, she do dawah, she do missionary between women, she is approved Muslim woman as a Sunni. You will see and you will notice that she is, she is presenting what the biggest sheikh of Islam says to her, what is lawful, what is not. So I want you to listen carefully and watch the video carefully, and please, after that, if you have my book, go and compare between what I told you about slavery in Islam and what the woman she is saying. So especially if you are a Muslim, and maybe some of you might say that I'm not telling the truth. Well, the truth always going to come, it's going to show up somehow. Doesn't matter how much you try to kill it. You cannot hide the sun by your finger or your hand, or even by closing your eyes. The sun is there. So let us see the truth, and the truth will set you free. This is a woman, her name is Salwa Al-Mtiri. She is from Kuwait, and Kuwait supposedly is a lot better than Saudi Arabia. Nothing to compare, like Saudi Arabia is very, very beyond. Kuwaiti are supposedly a lot more liberals comparing to the Saudi. So let us see what this Kuwaiti woman, she is saying, and watch with me this video.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Maakum Salwa Al-Mtiri. Ana adni rsala shwai ghariba. Wahid tajir قال لي إن يبي على حسب كلام عبدة وجارية وإنه ما راح يقصر وهذا وإنه بالإسلام محلل هذا الشيء صحيح كلام هو الرجال ما كذب. فموضوع هذا ذكرني موضوع قديم موضوع هذا قبل سنتين يمكن. كنت أعمل مع شخص هذا شخص ما شاء الله لساته شباب فشنو كان كثير يعرف نساء فكنت مشفقة لوضعه وكذلك مخلصة لعملي. فسبحان الله سنحت لي الفرصة اني ظروف اني ازور مكة. فلما زرت مكة طرى علي هو على وضعه وهذا ان المهم فدقيت على المفتين في مكة فقلت لهم عن وجهت سؤال عن يختص فيه قلت انه عنده حلال وعنده خير ويعني يحب النساء. فقلت شنو قانون الجواري؟ فقالوا قانون الجواري قال لي مفتي قانون الجواري ان لازم مسيحيه او دوله غير ليست على دين الاسلامي واسره لازم يكون اسره حرب. قلت هل هو حرام؟ قال لا بالدين مو حرام. الجواري ليس بالدين حرام، بالعكس الجارية قانونها غير عن قانون الحرة. الحرة عورتها كلها إلا وجهها ويدها، أما الجارية من السرة وتحت تختلف عن جدا عن الحرة. والحرة لازم عقد زواج، وهذا الجارية لا فقط يشتريها وخلاص كأنها تزوجها، فتختلف الجارية عن الحرة. طبعا هم كذلك هنا بالكويت سألت ناس مختصين متدينين وهذا فقالوا لي قالوا لي صح مشكلة استغفر الله يا ربي الرجل الملتزم أو الرجل اللي على دين مو إلا ملتزم حيل كل رجل سوي بدينه ويكون عنده خير. الحل الوحيد إنه لازم يكون عنده إذا يريد أن يأتي نساء الحرام إذا كان مبتلى بالفتنة إنه هذا هو الموضوع إنه يشتري جواري. فأنا شايفة إنه يعني يا ريت بالكويت يسن قانون ويعني لهذا لهذه الفئة، فئة الناس يعني الجواري. وأنا كذلك بالكويت شفت حالة إن واحدة يعني من دولة، يعني إن شاء الله أنا ما أشبهها بأنها جارية، بس مرت عليها هذه الحالة إن أهلها تخلوا عنها وهذا، فراحت سكنت عند واحدة يعني واحدة كويتية، فيعني كانت تطبخ لها وكانت تقوم بأعمال البيت وتساعدها. فأنا نظرت لها يعني قلت سبحان الله وضعها كأنه وضع الجارية، فهي تقول مو أحسن أبات بالشارع أو إني أمشي بالحرام؟ على الأقل الحمد لله يعني قاعدة ببيت وهذا مستورة، لأن أهلها تخلوا عنها والله يستر علينا عليها. فيعني استغفر الله عمي يغضب وجه الله. أنا صراحة أتمنى أن يسنون قانون لهذه الفئة ويفتحون يعني الباب لهذا، مثل ما فتحوا باب الخدم المكاتب وهذا، يفتحون باب الجواري ويسنون قانون صحيح. يعني إحنا ما نبي عيالنا يعني يضيعون بالهاوية، استغفر الله يا ربي، اللهم صغر كتب إليك، بالزنا والقذورات هذه. وإن شاء الله يا ربي يا كريم خير. وأنا الصراحة أنا الدول اللي أشوف إنها يعني مثل الشيشان اللي هي بينها حرب وبين دولة ثانية، أكيد في أسرة، فروح اشتروا هذول الأسرة، يعني ما أفضل يذبحهم الجوع هناك؟ روح اشتروهم وجسموا شغلوا هذا وبيعوهم على اللي التجار اللي بالكويت، أحسن من التجار يقعون بالحرام. فما فيها شيء، أنا شايفة ما فيها شيء. وأكبر ما مثل بأنه كان عنده كثير من الجواري هارون رشيد، لما توفى وجدوا عنده 2000 جارية، فمو عيب ولو حرام، وكانت عنده زوجة واحدة فقط، فمو عيب ولو حرام، يعني شريعتنا محلل الشيء هذا. والحمد لله الكويت يعني فيها كثير من التجار واللي ملتزمين، وأتمنى الكويت للأفضل إن شاء الله.
So this is what she is wishing. She is wishing the government in her country to allow the law. Actually, they have it already, but it's not a law. People, they own slaves still until now in Kuwait, in Saudi Arabia, but they don't speak about it in international. You can go and search for slavery in Emirat, in Bahrain, in Qatar, in Saudi Arabia, etc. But look how filthy this woman is. To the point, she's a woman. Like, don't you feel for women at least? Don't you have a shame? Like a woman, she should feel for other women. She's saying to them, okay, in Chechnya as an example, those are Muslims having war with the Russian, and for sure they have prisoners. Let us buy them. Let us buy those girls so our men they can have sex with them. Like, can you find a shameful nation like those? They have no shame. And this is a woman. If a woman she is thinking this way, the man will say what? And look, she was working with the man, and this man is so always he's so horny. How you know he's horny? You must be a whore. How you know that he is always horny? Because now the reason she is opening the topic, she is speaking about a man she knew, he want women. How you know he not want? Like what? He came to you, he want to have sex with you? Trash society, trash religion. And look, the mullahs, they say to her, yes, it's allowed, but we need to capture prisoners, we need to capture Christian women, and then we can rape them. And then they go to America, they say to you, oh, Islam is against slavery, when the Quran is full of it. The Prophet himself, didn't he accept Maria the Copt as a gift, her and her cousin? He accepted a human being to be gifted to him as a gift. And then they say to you, Muhammad against slavery. Isn't it him who captured many people and he had them as slaves, including Juria, who later became his wife because he wanted to have an agreement with her tribe so they don't ask for revenge for killing her tribe, for her uncles from different tribes, to have a settlement with them? Okay, I will marry your daughter. So the filthy people, they speak in America about how Islam free people, make them equal. In the same time, what do you hear in the Middle East about the real Islam is totally different. This is the real Islam, not the one you hear from this liar Yusuf State, the potato in the Dean show. Do he dare to debate me? Or Abdullah Green, the other idiot, do they dare to debate me? A bunch of liars. Spread this video, please. Give it to everybody. Don't forget to download it. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. Amen to that. Thank you.